Hello, welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect 3, Blind. My voice is weird. I'm the RPG chick, going to do an N7 mission. Looks like the only mission before the main quest continues. That's the main, I'm guessing, in N7 communication hub is what we're heading for now. Citadel, Cerberus, Ciphers, we either missed on a previous mission or we're gonna find it here or here, I'm not sure. But anyway. Leaving Thessia, which is like utterly destroyed. Citadel. Right, main quest, sanctuary. Kepler Verge, that's new. Let me just check. Nubian, was that, is that new? I don't remember Nubian Expanse. They're adding stuff. I know I don't... What do we have here written? Apian Crest, Petra Nebula, Cigarette's Cradle, Anos Base, and Ninmah Cluster, Arcturus Stream, Kite's Nest, Horsehead Nebula, Shrike Abyssal, Ismar Frontier, Exodus Cluster, Gemini Sigma, Hades Gamma, Crescent Nebula, Minos Wasteland, Calliston Rift, Pylos Nebula, Sigurd's Cradle, Aethon Cluster, Attican Beta, Athena Cluster, Valhalla Threshold, Nimbus Cluster. Did I read that one off already? Oh, Nimbus Cluster is continuing, I think? I'm not sure. Nimbus Cluster, Far Rim, Perseus Vale, Hades Nexus. And... Argus Row and Cilian Nebula. I wrote Nebulo. So we definitely know Nubian Expanse. We have to check that out. As well as Kepler Verge. Looking for any more. That's our gas station right there. This thing's flashing, there's no reason for it to be flashing, but it is. Did I read off Hourglass Nebula? Wait. Sorry guys. Just... It doesn't have the percent listed, so... It's a good thing I write this crap down. I don't see it so far. Do-do-do. I don't see an Hourglass Nebula. So we got Hourglass, we got another one to do, and then where the main quest is. Let's check out Hourglass Nebula. There's some more stuff to... planets to look at and resources to find. You guys could even hear that. Osen? Arinal? Arunmila? Aganju? Yeah, I don't remember the stuff. Okay, Osen system then. Guess this is gonna be another exploration. Planet exploration resource finding thing. So Orinmila. A medium-sized gas giant, Orinmila is close enough to its parent star to suffer massive changes in temperature during its day and night periods. This leads to powerful convection currents and storms throughout its hydrogen-helium atmosphere. Gathering helium-3 to refuel is possible for the hardiest of exploration craft, but lesser ships are nearly always lost in the attempt. Orinmila is within the frost line of its solar system, where icy cored gas giants do not usually form. For this reason, it is believed to be an extrasolar planet captured by its star's gravity. That happens a lot. Extra solar captures. Erinal? Erinlay, whatever. Erinal is a garden world in its last stages of habitability. While its soil still supports agriculture, its animal biodiversity has fallen to record lows, and the most successful remaining life is toxic blue-green algae and insect-like pest species. A large Solarian colony is trying to restore biodiversity to the planet, but setbacks are a fact of life. Mineral and fuel mining remains lucrative, however, and Erinal has a thriving spaceport that refuels many ships passing into the terminus systems. Third one is Aganju. Aganju is an extremely large rock planet with a thin atmosphere of hydrogen and carbon monoxide. Abundant in both copper and platinum, the crust has been scanned by mining bots from Erinal, but the specialized equipment to work in Aganju's heavy gravity more than 5 Gs has created prohibitive costs, and so Aganju is largely unexploited. That's pretty crushing gravity. Would be comfy to an Elcor, though. Ulukan. Ulukan, or Sky Harvest, is a standard gas giant composed of hydrogen and helium. The spacefarers from Erinal gather helium-3 from here rather than Oren Mila, as its atmosphere is much more predictable. And that's it for these planets. No, we find anything here. I think I remember this system from previous game or two. Now when we get to Mass Effect Andromeda, that's going to be all new. Wait.
I found something.
You found two somethings. A paltry 100 units of fuel. We're full anyway. And something on Erinal. I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right or what. Probe away. Credits. Was it 10,000? Or 100,000? Either way, it's good. Credits never hurt. Good, 100%. So we've got, I guess, three more systems? Yep. Let's go to Far Yar, which is quite far. Oh, I do remember that So Willow planet. System. Okay, Far Yar system. Planet Quarim. A scorchingly hot planet close to its parent star, Quarim was bombarded by comets and asteroids during its earliest geological periods. As the solar system stabilized, these occurrences leveled off until the planet became geologically inactive. Its hydrogen and helium atmosphere is extremely thick due to heavy metals, making the planet's core very dense. Unfortunately, these metals are deep below the crust, making mining impractical. Crazy gravity going on there as well. Daratar. Though ancient riverbeds crisscross the plains of Daratar, photodissociation has long since dried up the world. There are indications of ancient mining operations, but any structures have long since been buried or worn away by the planet's seasonal dust storms. And this third, Tunfigel. First charted by the Solarians, Tunfigel, or Hard Heart, is noted for its platinum and uranium deposits, making robo-mining a lucrative activity. While the surface temperature is well within the range of a comfortable EVA excursion, the extremely dense Tunfigel creates a dangerous gravitational pull 5 times that of Earth. The Solarian miners exploiting the planet derisively nicknamed planets such as these Elcor Taurus traps. We'll be picking on the Elcor. Next one is Nephros. Some small planet descriptions here. Nephros, or Restless Sleep, is a relatively small hydrogen-nitrogen gas giant. Its atmosphere is home to spectacular winds of up to 350 kilometers per hour and electrical storms up to 700 times the power of those of Earth, which indicate that its hydrogen clouds contain moderate amounts of water vapor. Next is... here. Elingon. Elingon, or Deceptive, was so named by Solarian scouts because as their probes landed on the planet, their instruments started going awry. This turned out to be due to the high concentration of magnetically active periclase, magnesia, in the core and crust of the planet. This interferes with scans and broadcasts, which has given rise to countless spacer stories of pirates lying in wait in Elingon's magnetosphere, or crashed ships with untold fortunes stranded on the surface. In reality, any pirates would have a hard time locating prey amongst all the interference, and would live lives cut off from the rest of the galaxy as the magnetosphere kills extraplanetary communication. Elingon's other natural features are a thin atmosphere of carbon dioxide, spectacular dry ice formations, and xenon gas, which can be skimmed from the upper atmosphere and used in ion thrusters. Neat. Very neat. We've got two more planets. Got this little guy. Wenrum. Wenrum, or White Knight, takes its name from a Solarian story in the Romantic period of a knight who refused all temptation to riches, carnality, and even flavorful food until justice was served to the poor and oppressed. The planet is so named because of its white, highly reflective surface, composed mainly of titanium dioxide and ice, and no atmosphere to speak of to dim its albedo. Finally, up here. Antictra. Antictra, fused metal, is so named because of its spectacular craters. A planet high in various grades of iron oxide, Antictra is regularly pummeled by loose asteroids in the nearby belt between it and Wenrum. The iron melted and fused by the incoming meteors makes for spectacular landscape shots that look alien no matter what part of the galaxy you may be from. However, due to frequent meteor impacts, exploration is considered highly dangerous, even to those with advanced kinetic barriers. Alright, what about this asteroid belt? See if there's anything here. Some fuel we can get. That's two.
Signal confirmed.
Here we go. They're putting them together. That's really convenient. Cool. Elingon. Probe away. Shadow Broker Starship Tech. Cool. New asset. And we're done. Pretty easy so far. And our fuel is full, so we'll go to So Willow. The eye in the middle is so spooky. It's Azathoth. Aruz. A large rock planet with a pressure cooker atmosphere of nitrogen and argon, Aruz's silicate-rich crust is relatively low density. It was largely ignored by the Solarian explorers who first charted the system. Short but sweet. Kanaz. Kanaz's extremely thin atmosphere is mostly methane and helium. The Solarian explorers who named the system set up a small mining presence for recovering nickel and chromium, used in making stainless steels. Hourglass. I remember Hourglass. Didn't we have a mission on Hourglass? Hourglass is a second-tier garden world that received little attention from the galactic community. A Solarian mining expedition initially discovered the planet, which was promptly strong-armed away from them by organized crime figures. Hourglass's exploration rights were then sold to the highest bidder, which led to a brief burst of mining colonies in the 2000s, but most of those were abandoned when other planets were found with more accessible resources. Though Hourglass has a nitrogen-oxygen atmosphere capable of supporting life, its rotational period is slower than Earth's, making its day and night 98 days Earth days long. The intense heat on one side of the planet and the extreme cold on the other make for violent storm cells whenever the sun is rising or setting. This is where the Shadow Broker ship is, the original, well, not the original, but the Shadow Broker that existed before Liara took over. That thing. I can't remember the name of it. I can never remember the name of that thing. With the six eyes. Which is... We deemed it, not worthy. Too dangerous to be given spacefaring capability. You guys know what I'm talking about. Anyway, as a result, the flora and fauna of Hourglass have developed the capability to live in the cycles of ice, flooding, baking heat, and dramatic air pressure changes. The biota of the planet has been largely unexploited by the exotic pet and gardening trades, since simulating their natural conditions is problematic for the average consumer. The Yogg. That's what they called, the Yogg. That's what I was trying to think of. Ansuz. A large rock planet, Ansuz, was once under development by a consortium of robo-mining interests, but an epidemic of accidents and sabotage cost the lives of hundreds of workers and eventually drove them off the world. Despite numerous accusations among the mining corporations and a dozen or more trials, popular opinion holds that the real saboteurs were never found. Got a gas giant. Thursaz. A hydrogen helium gas giant, Thursaz has a decrepit automated infrastructure for refueling merchant vessels with helium 3. Painted onto the metal in a Solarian dialect are the words self-serve. That's funny. I can't move. I literally couldn't move. I was stuck. Well, at least that worked. There, there, there. There, okay. Making sure I didn't miss one. Issa. A rock and ice planet, Issa has, a thin atmosphere of methane and ethane. Its borax deposits, largely trapped beneath the ice, were never considered valuable enough to mine since synthetic substitutes and alternative sources became widely available. Okay, now we look for resources. Aha! I'm finding them quickly.
I found something.
(Clears throat) 200 units of fuel. We are full. Here we are. Wait! We're doing well. I think I need a bigger mouse pad. Probe away. Shadow Broker support team. Nice. The Shadow Broker. assets. Okay. Just in time, too. One more. Ploitari. It looks like... I could be wrong. It looks like there's only one asset to find in here. Okay. A few planets. Agila. Only known from scan data picked up by space probes, Agila is currently classified as a dwarf planet. A warm, barren rock, its thin atmosphere is composed of carbon dioxide and oxygen. Significant alumina deposits in its crust make its density and gravity very low indeed. Zenethu. Believed to be a post-garden world, Zenethu has large deposits of calcium carbonate in its sedimentary rocks, indicating it may have once had plate tectonics and even plant life. Its swirling clouds of dust and snow may have occurred more recently and blocked the sun, creating a mass extinction event. Its surface gravity is comfortable and its temperature tolerable by most sapient species. Well, that's nice. Right now, sapient species are on a run. Sinilus. Okay, sorry guys, I got interrupted by... I don't know. I had this defrag program that... I don't know, I guess must have reactivated itself at some point. It decided to start defragging and just quit out of the game, but... Well, it minimized the game. It alt-tabbed me out. Anyway, space probes indicate that Sinilus is nowhere near as hospitable as its neighbor Zenethu. Sinilus's hydrogen-argon atmosphere is thought to be anathema to life, but the presence of borax on the surface spawned by a boron-heavy core indicates the planet may have once had water. And finally, this is a small system as far as how much we have to run around, so it should be easy. Thegan rounds out the trio of planets only scouted by space probe in this backwater solar system. A frozen ball with significant amounts of tin in its crust, Thegan has a fractional atmosphere with trace amounts of carbon dioxide and carbon monoxide. Strange radiation emissions have been charted coming off of Thegan, but it is unknown if these are from radioactive elements or merely a star's radiation reflected by a high albedo surface. Okay. Let's see what we can find. It might just be a planet. Like I said, it looks like there's only one thing to find here. One asset.
Signal confirmed.
Oh my. Especially since I only did that... I only did one scan and they're like all over the place now. Up here somewhere... Probe away. Terminus freighters. Cool. And we're done. That was right. Done with this system. Right. I would keep going, but I mean, it's a little bit of a shorter episode, but yeah, it's this entire cluster. So, we'll be heading for the next one. Where are we going next? The one that doesn't have a quest in it. Nubian Expanse. And from there, Kepler Verge. Next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.